Hello class. In this video, we're going to talk about dentition, and particularly mammalian dentition. And we're going to focus on several different avenues here, just to give you an idea of what the teeth can tell us about a species. So if we look here, we have a human cranium, a chimpanzee cranium, Australopithecus afarensis cranium, a bobcat cranium, and a horse cranium. And so first thing I wanted to say was that mammals, so we're in the group mammals, right? We're in the class of mammals. We have different types of teeth. This is called heterodonty. Heterodonty means that we have different types of teeth. Lots of animals only have one type of tooth, like for instance, sharks or crocodiles. They have one type of tooth. They have many of them, but there's really just one type of tooth there. On the other hand, mammals usually have four different types of teeth. These are called incisors, canines, premolars, and molars. So let's start with looking at the human. The incisors, the front teeth, there are four of them. These are teeth that are relatively flat-shaped, kind of like a shovel. They have one sharp ridge along the bottom edge, and these types of teeth are used for pulling into things and pulling it off. So give a great example of contemporary use. When you go to pull a staple out of a piece of paper, you can use these front teeth to pull it out. Just behind that are the canines, one on either side, and also in the bottom jaw, there's one on either side. These canines are used for biting and tearing as well. They just have one point at the edge of them. Then we move back into premolars. Premolars are here. Premolars are used for grinding and chewing. And then we have molars. Molars are the ones found in the back. Molars are also used for, well, mostly used for chewing and grinding. Okay. So we have incisors, canines, premolars, and molars. Now, if you look at the dental arcade, you'll see that they go in a certain order. So the incisors are always at the front of the mouth. And as we move backward, we go incisors, canine, premolars, molars. This is true in all mammals. And so we can do something called the dental formula. And what the dental formula is basically we count, starting at the mid-sagittal plane and moving in this direction, we can count the types of teeth there are. So we start off with there are two incisors at the front, two incisors, one canine, two premolars, and then three molars. This means that our dental formula for humans is 2-1-2-3. We have two incisors, one canine, two premolars, three molars on either side of our mouth. Then at the bottom in the mandible, we have the same thing. Two incisors, one canine, two premolars, and three molars. And so therefore, our dental arcade is 2-1-2-3/2-1-2-3. That is the human dental formula. So let's take a look at a couple other things. This is a cat. A carnivore, a bobcat to be specific, and if we look, this cat has small incisors up in the front, so same type of teeth, large canines, so they're different, but they still have the canines, and then they have one premolar and one molar. So their dental formula is actually 3-1-1-1. So they have a different dental formula than us. One thing I want to say about the shape of the teeth, check it out. So these are very pointy teeth. These are their chewing and grinding teeth. They don't have to do a lot of grinding or chewing. They're only eating meat, and it doesn't take a lot of chewing and grinding to get the meat to a point where they can swallow and digest it. Okay. Now let's take a look at the cranium of the horse. And so we don't have the front teeth on this cranium, and that's okay. I'm not gonna really focus on that anyway. They have incisors just like we do. And I wanted to look at these back teeth here. These are their premolars and molars. look at the difference between these molars and those of the cat here and humans. You can see that these are pretty extensive. They have all these ridge lines along them. They're huge. There are many of them. And this is their most important set of teeth. This is where when you go by a horse and you're hanging around with them and they're just chomping and chomping and chomping and chomping all on the hay, that's these teeth grinding up and chopping up that hay. The reason why is the grains that they eat are so complex that it's really difficult for our stomachs to break them down. So the horse or the cow or any of the herbivores, they need these really big and complex molars and premolars to grind all that stuff down. So they spend a lot of their time chewing. Okay, moving back to the human, you can see that our teeth are neither like the cat nor the horse. They're actually intermediate. That is because we are not carnivores and we are not herbivores, but we are omnivores. Our teeth, if you look at our molars in comparison to either the cat or the horse, our molars are rounded and there's a couple of ridges, but there's not a whole mess of ridges and the size like on a horse. However, they're also not just points sticking out like on the cat. They're in the middle. That's because sometimes we eat meat and sometimes we eat vegetables. We're omnivores. And as I point out later on in the comparison of the skull and the cat, the skull of the monkey and the cat, you'll see that all primates have dentition like ours. For example, here is the chimpanzee. As you can see, the chimpanzee has the exact same dental formula that we do. Two incisors, one canine, two premolars, and three molars. And as you can see, the chimpanzee's teeth, the shape of their teeth, is nearly identical to ours, except for the canine. The canine is larger, and we will be talking about that later on. But they are omnivores just like we are omnivores. This shows our close relationship and how we fit within the primate order. Okay. One last thing I just wanted to talk about is the shape of the canines. So the canines in apes, although they're much larger than ours, they have a much different function than those of the canines in a cat or a dog. In a cat or a dog, the canines are very sharp and pointy on the end, and they bite in to kill their prey. Chimpanzees don't use their teeth to kill their prey. If they actually go hunting, they tear their prey apart with their hands and their arm strength. So they actually don't kill anything by biting into it. Instead, what these teeth are used for, and you can see in the back here, the tooth is rather than sharp on the end, it's sharp on the back edge, and that's used for striating things like fruit and things like that, cutting into and sort of pulling off pieces of fruit in the denser kind of when it has a shell or whatever else. So the canines look more like a cat's canines, but they function quite differently. And they have teeth much more like ours, which shows that they're omnivorous.